Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. In today's video we shall consider the syllabus orientation for the subject Pharmacology 3 under the 4th year B.Pharm semester 7 syllabus. So these are the details of the course with the code of BPH C704T, and the credits allotted to this particular subject is 4 depending upon the number of hours per week. So the credit points which are earned after you clear this particular subject are 4 as per the University of Mumbai syllabus. Now coming to the weightage for this particular course, so it's a 100 marks course which is divided into two parts, that is internal assessment and the end semester examination. Okay. So internal assessment carries 20 marks and the end semester exam, which is the final exam conducted after completion of the entire syllabus, it is of 80 marks. Now coming to the distribution of the internal assessment. So out of the 20 marks, 5 marks are reserved for the attendance of the learner. So these marks are allotted as per your final percent attendance. We'll come to that in the next slide. And the mid-semester test or the examination, that is conducted out of 15 marks. Now coming to the distribution of the marks for the attendance as per the percent attendance, the marks can be allotted as follows. The attendance of more than 90% or 90% or more will be allotted 5 marks, full 5 marks. Attendance of 85 to 89% will be allotted 4 marks. If you have attendance falling in between 80 to 84, 3 marks will be allotted to you, and in case of 75 to 79% of attendance, 2 marks will be allotted, and any percentage below 75 will lead to loss of all 5 marks. So attendance carries 5 marks as per the final attendance, percent attendance of the learner. Coming to the course objectives. Upon completion of this particular course, the student should be able to educate on different drugs which are acting on the CNS, central nervous system, and the diseases which are associated with the CNS, different disorders and diseases which you all have studied under the CNS. The second objective is to educate on the pharmacology of the anti-inflammatory drugs, drugs which act against the inflammation. Third objective is to impart the knowledge on pharmacology of drugs which are used in inflammatory disorders. Say for example, asthma or the gout, these are the inflammatory disorders. So the pharmacology of the drugs which are used in such conditions. To educate on the autocoids and the drugs impacting the autocoids' actions. Autocoids are the substances which are present in the body normally, which are released in response to the certain alteration in the physiology, maybe in response to the inflammation. Certain mediators are released, right? So such type of substances are known as autocoids. So there may be drugs which can alter the actions of these autocoids. Okay, so such drugs also are studied under this particular subject. Then the next objective is to provide the understanding about the drugs which are used in GIT associated disorders. Say for example, ulcer or diarrhea, constipation, and nausea, vomiting. Next objective is to convey the principles of toxicity with briefing on common toxicants such as say heavy metal poisoning. such as the arsenic, lead, or the pesticide poisoning, insecticide poisoning, and so on. Then coming to the course outcomes. So after completion of this particular course, the student will be able to explain the pharmacology of the drugs which are acting on CNS and the associated diseases. Also, to classify and explain the pharmacology of the anti-inflammatory drugs and make use of this knowledge of about these particular drugs to justify their use in these inflammatory disorders like asthma and gout. And the next course outcome is to discuss the pharmacology of the drugs used in the gastrointestinal disorders, which we have seen just now. Also, to know the toxic effects of heavy metals or certain drugs and the environmental toxicants which are released in the environment as they are used in the community. So with this, we'll begin with the actual syllabus. So the first unit under the syllabus is the drugs acting on the central nervous system, which is allotted 24 hours. So there are several chapters which are included under this particular unit. So this is the vastest of all the units. So weightage wise, it carries half of the hours, total hours, which are allotted to the entire syllabus. So there are number of chapters which you all are going to study under this. So first chapter under drugs acting on the central nervous system is the aliphatic alcohol. So you'll be studying about the ethanol and the methanol, their actions, their mechanism of action, okay, toxicity which can be caused by these aliphatic alcohols and how it can be treated. So it's allotted 2 hours. Next chapter is general and local anesthetics. So these are the drugs which are used to abolish all the sensations in particular area under local anesthetic, or the whole body under the general anesthetic. So you will be studying about the stages of anesthesia under general anesthetics, the mechanisms, different types of anesthetics, the general anesthetic as well as local anesthetic, pre-anesthetic medication under this particular two chapters, which are allotted with 4 hours. Then the third chapter included under this unit is sedatives, hypnotics, and anxiolytic agents. Okay, so sedative hypnotics are the drugs which are used to calm down the patient or to induce the sleep. The barbiturates, benzodiazepines, and newer non-benzodiazepine class which you will be studying under this. So you'll be studying about the two main classes, that is barbiturates and benzodiazepines. Benzodiazepines have a vast application, and since it is related, anxiolytic drugs are related to these class, that is the benzodiazepines. So hence it is explained together, or it can be discussed together. So 3 hours are allotted for this particular chapter. And the fourth chapter is anti-epileptic drugs, so drugs which are used in the treatment of epilepsy. So 2 hours are allotted for this particular chapter. Next chapter is the drugs which are used in the Parkinson's disease. So Parkinson's disease, which is associated with the rigidity, okay, abnormal posture, gait, okay, even the movement is affected in these particular patients. Okay. So the drugs which are used in the treatment of Parkinson's disease can be studied over here, okay, such as levodopa, which is the first line treatment. Of course, there are other drugs also which are important, which can be prescribed along with this. The 2 hours are allotted for this particular chapter. And the next one is drugs which are used in the Alzheimer's disease, wherein the memory may get affected. So it's a type of dementia wherein there is memory loss. So usually it is thought that this condition is associated with the age. Usually it is found in the elderly patients. But nowadays this particular condition coexists in the younger individuals also. Okay. So this particular chapter is allotted 2 hours. नेक्स्ट वन इज द एंटी साइकोटिक ड्रग्स, एंटी साइकोटिक्स, एंटी डिप्रेसेंट्स एंड एंटी मानिया ड्रग्स. ओके, सो दिस एंटी साइकोटिक ड्रग्स आर द वंस सच एज द फिनोथायाजिन्स और द ब्यूटेरोफिनोन्स और द अटिपिकल एंटी साइकोटिक ड्रग्स विच आर क्वाइट कॉमनली यूज नाउअडेज फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ शिजोफ्रेनिया. एंटी डिप्रेसेंट्स नेम इज वेरी क्लियर, द ड्रग्स विच आर यूज इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ डिप्रेशन. And mania, it's a condition exactly opposite to depression, irritable behavior. Okay, so anti-manic drugs. So these three chapters have been allotted 4 hours. Next chapter is the opioid analgesics. So analgesics, painkillers in the layman's term. Okay, so these are the drugs which can abolish the pain. So opioid analgesics are the ones which have central mechanisms. So hence it is discussed under the drugs acting on the CNS, and 3 hours has been allotted for this particular chapter, in which morphine will be studied in detail, and of course the other drugs like codeine, pethidine and so on. Then the last chapter under the CNS is the CNS stimulant drug. Okay, so these are the drugs which will stimulate the CNS and result in excitation. So generally these are the drugs which can induce the convulsions due to their property. Okay, so most of these drugs included under this particular chapter, these are used as a laboratory tools, or certain drugs like amphetamines, these may be used to produce the alertness in certain disorders. Okay, so 2 hours have been allotted to this particular chapter. Then the next unit is the autocoids and the drug therapy of inflammation. Yes, 13 hours have been allotted for this particular unit. So various types of autocoids will be studied under this. Okay, so we'll be studying the synthesis of a particular autocoid, how exactly it is synthesized, what are the pharmacological actions, what are the pathophysiological roles in which it is involved, and what are the different drugs which are acting on that particular type of autocoids, maybe by interacting with the receptors, affecting the synthesis, okay, or affecting the receptors. Okay, say the first chapter under this is the histamine and the bradykinin and their antagonists. So antihistaminics are the drugs which are quite commonly used in allergic condition, because histamine is a very popular as far as hypersensitivity reactions are considered. Okay, also the bradykinin. Okay, so you'll be studying about the histamine, bradykinin and their antagonists as the therapeutic agent. So 2 hours have been allotted for this chapter. Then the second chapter under this is serotonin or 5-hydroxytryptamine. So along with its agonist and antagonist, which have therapeutic 2 hours have been allotted for this particular chapter. Next one is the lipid derivative autocoids, that is the eicosanoids. Okay, that is under this we'll be studying about the prostaglandins, the leukotrienes and the thromboxanes, okay, as well as the platelet activating factor. Okay, so these are the two lipid derivative autocoids will be studied, along with their pharmacological actions and their pathophysiological roles, and the receptors and their agonist antagonist. So 2 hours have been allotted for this particular chapter. Then the next one is the NSAIDs, that is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. So these are the analgesics which are acting by peripheral mechanisms. Okay, that is generally by inhibiting the synthesis of this prostaglandins. Okay, so 3 hours have been allotted for this particular chapter. Next one is the drug therapy of the inflammatory conditions, that is the pharmacotherapy of asthma, which is one of the inflammatory disorder. Okay, so 2 hours have been allotted for this chapter, and the pharmacotherapy of the gout. Okay, so this is a particular condition wherein there is a deposition of the crystals in the joints. So joint pain, it's associated with the joint pain. Okay, so 2 hours have been allotted for this chapter. So this to do with the autocoids and the drug therapy of the inflammation. And the third unit is the drugs acting on the gastrointestinal tract, which is allotted with the 8 hours. Under this, the first chapter is antacids and drugs for the peptic ulcer. So we'll be studying antacids along with other drugs which are utilized for the peptic ulcer treatment, like the H2 blockers or the proton pump inhibitors and so on. So 3 hours have been allotted for this chapter. Next one is the emetics, anti-emetics and prokinetics. Okay, so emetics are the drugs which are used to induce the vomiting. So when do you need to induce vomiting? In case of poisoning. Anti-emetics, which will be utilized to prevent the vomiting, which may be of different types, the ones which is associated with traveling, or maybe cancer chemotherapy, or which is associated with the pregnancy and so on. Okay, so anti-emetic drugs, one of the important classes is the prokinetics. Okay, so which we'll be studying in detail. So 2 hours have been allotted for these chapters. Next one is the drugs for constipation and diarrhea, wherein the motility is affected. GI motility may be affected. Okay, so 2 hours have been allotted for this chapter. Next one is the drugs for inflammatory bowel diseases. That is the ulcerative colitis and the Crohn's disease. So 1 hour has been allotted to this chapter, and the last unit is the principles of the toxicology, okay, carrying the 3 hours. So you will be studying about the heavy metal poisoning, that is lead, mercury and arsenic. These are the heavy metals. So you will be studying about the poisoning, that is the symptoms and the treatment of these heavy metals. So 2 hours for heavy metal poisoning and pesticide and opioid poisoning and its treatment. So 1 hour has been allotted for this particular chapter. Okay. So this to do with the syllabus, which is including the drugs which are acting on the CNS, the GIT, then the autocoagulants and inflammation, and the toxicology. So a total of 48 hours have been allotted for this particular subject, pharmacology. Thank you for watching.